The evolutionary process is one that takes hundreds of thousands of years, right? Not so much. For some species, we're seeing evolution right in front of our eyes. This is what's called rapid evolution, where major environmental changes in predation, food, or climate can alter the natural selection to favor genes that were previously disadvantaged. It can happen in a very short amount of time. For example, in a period of just 5 years, male Polynesian field crickets in Hawaii lost their ability to make noise. They did this to avoid parasitic attacks. That's one of the fastest evolutions in the wild ever recorded. Graduating college can take longer than that. I took 5 years. Basically, one gene mutation led to a very silent cricket. And this silence helped him avoid the parasitic attacks that were killing his brothers. The problem is, the female crickets, they liked the song. So without it, the silent males needed to change their behavior. So they started creeping on the singing males, mating with those females that would show up, and they passed on their mutation. Boom. Rapid evolution. All this happened in just 5 years, and now 90% of the population is songless. This fast-moving evolution isn't exactly what Charles Darwin envisioned way back in 1859. He thought any changes would take many generations, which sounds like a long time, but it doesn't have to be. Darwin knew almost nothing about genetics. He was simply observing patterns in the wild. But he couldn't pinpoint why or really how long these things could take. But now with advances in modern technology and molecular biology, we can. Evolutionary biologists can identify and track the exact gene adaptations that species have over time. But it ain't the 19th century anymore. And the environment for our planet's little critters is changing quicker than ever before. What used to take hundreds of years can now take a few because the animals are keeping up with their rapidly changing surroundings. In just 15 years, green anole lizards in Florida have evolved to have better grips in their feet to escape invasive species. Tawny owls, typically a gray dominant species, are now becoming more brown as winters grow warmer. And maybe closer to home, in the last 50 years, bedbugs have developed stronger enzymes to make themselves more resistant to insecticide. You might think you're safe because humans were apex predators, right? But you're not. Organisms can acclimate fast, and this includes pathogens that can harm humans and tumors that can resist chemotherapy. So, yeah, humans should also pay attention to rapid evolution. But now that we know about this, the better we understand how our environment can affect our genes and have a greater chance to create better medicine and other means of improving our longevity. We've come a long way from Darwin simply observing finches in the wild, but we still have a long way to go. Hey, apex predators, do you like science in your day? Go ahead and check us out now on Prime Video. We have made it to the big screen. You can stream all of the episodes you love, ad-free, all in one place. We'll throw the link in the description below, and you can always find us at Seeker on Twitter, and now at Prime Video as well. Fun fact, Darwin went to the Galapagos and noted how different finches all had different beaks, and today we know it's the gene, BMP4, that helps determine the different beaks of the finches that he based his first theories of evolution on. Cool, huh? Thanks for watching.